We're pleased to see both those amazing portraits here. I mean, personally, I've been seeing these for a few years now, and I never tire of them. They're just, I mean, to see this level of craftsmanship and rendering is really astonishing in 2012. So, and for those of you who went to the LA Art Show in January, you also got a little preview of this show. So we're pleased to see some of these pieces here and kind of expansion of what was vision. So we'll go.
First of all, I want to say thank you for that opportunity to show my work. I really was looking forward to it, and I just can't stop appreciating that. I'm glad that I become a member of this place, and just want to do best and best and best. So I immigrated to America in 2000, and in 2003 I got involved in Florida City College, and then I was studying art in Russia, and preliminary education I received from a regular Russian school, which was focused on that kind of representing the figure we call social realism. And of course, in my work is big influence, and you know, whatever I do, I'm kind of like making statement by making the subject matter look stoic. So that's kind of a principle that I still have, and I probably want to use it for in my further work. So I learned my skills, how to do the craftsman skills, how to use materials, how to draw, how to, you know, make a painting. I learned in Russia, and then in America I started to learn about a concept, which is, I realize, it's very important, and I think it should be there, because art is not only amusement, although a big part of it is, and I'm still looking for that. I want my work be amusing, first of all, for myself when I'm doing portraits, you know, because if I don't have that satisfaction while I'm working, then, you know, there, for me, it's like, doesn't force to work on it. It should give me that amusement. And then, of course, if my work look amusing for other people, I'm just getting more and more positive vibes, and, you know, I want to make more work, you know, just to show off. So when I start to work on concept in Otis, I mean, I already did some portraits. So this was my first portrait that I did. That was the ruins of it from a Renaissance period painting of Leonardo da Vinci. I did that work, I did enjoy it, I looked for the person to do that portrait, and I met the person in the Lacey College, and I did this painting, and I was really into it, like for whole months I was working on it, I just couldn't stop, I was working on it like day and night, I wanted to be right, I wanted to be beautiful, I wanted to be recognizable as Leonardo, you know, anybody would look at it, would recognize that, oh, this is Leonardo da Vinci painting, you know, so. Sometimes, you know, like people saying that this copy after Leonardo da Vinci, instead of be upset, I kind of like feel that I'm flattered, you know? It's wrong for me. And then in audience, somebody said, oh, I know artists who does that kind of work, and that artist is really... Yes, that one. God, somebody already doing that. Should I stop, or I just want to, you know, should continue? And then I saw his work, and work is gorgeous, beautiful, he's not here. But he kind of like stick with the same gender, same color, you know. And I thought, okay, so there's something from this, since there are women, there are different personalities, you know, different ages, different, you know, social, place, so okay, so there is still room for me, you know, so I still continue to do that, and I don't think that I'm a follower, but you know, if somebody thinks so, again, it's also flattering because he's such a great artist. And then, you know, what frames, my frames are, motion to make more conceptual, because I wanted to make a statement that, you know, each person in this world born good, as any person who were depicted during the Renaissance period, as any person who born, you know, 10 years ago, 15 years ago, 20 years ago. So we are same. Like, I mean, we're supposed to be better because, you know, according to Darwin theory, we are anybody who got into work, they are the best. They are the best of the best, you know. If they were able to survive, it means only the best survive, right? So I guess anybody who I need to paint is the best. This is why I'm painting them. And to frame them with that gold frame, even bring that statement, the observation, you know, because I wanted to pop up on, you know, the gold frame, the stable pose of the person, and, you know, nicely done with such good craft that I'm able to do. So I just want to pull it together and make it, you know, noticeable. So we'll see that. Doesn't matter if you know the person. Doesn't matter. The person is still the best. And you are the best. I mean, anybody. And
but the frames are fragmented.
Yes. So by that, thank you. By that, I have a statement saying that I'm combining old and new and making it again beautiful and strong. That's the basic concept. So as my work is a combination of old and new, so it's frame. So I wanted my frame to be part of the work, part of the love concept. And be honest, I made those frames with my bare hands as painting, so it's also kind of like part of artwork. And this is my last painting that I did specially for this show, since at the LA Art Show, one of my work was sold that I was thinking to submit for the show. So I had to hurry up and paint it, you know, for, you know, to replace them. And yeah, pretty much.
I'm curious about that work because all the rest have classical backgrounds.
Yeah,
not like this. So.
Yeah, that was, I kind of wanted to be deep with that painting, that why I put that square of the sky in the blue square. And another part is the painting of, he's one of my classmates from Otis College. And the painting behind him is work of another my classmate that I'm thinking to support it. So it's all of it known by me, you know, so it's part of my life. And all of my models are part of my life. I met them. They're my neighbors, they're my classmates, they're my friends, and myself. So it depends where I live. I'm an artist, I paint people from the artist. I'm in a downtown, in Koreatown, I'm painting people from my building. I'm with friends, I'm painting friends. So it's wherever I am, I just meet somebody and paint.
What's your process? Are you having them sit down or are you doing it from photographs?
The only painting that I painted from real model is my self-portrait. I painted it from the mirror. Everybody else are painted from photographs. I used to have photographs of the Renaissance period master work. Painted the photograph of the work and the photograph of my model. And when I'm working, I kind of keeping up with the palette of old work and appearance of person that I'm painting.
So you have a specific master work that you're modeling on?
Yes.
So every painting is after a different specific work?
Pretty much, yes, except myself.
Because some of them have this black background and some of them have this looking very Renaissance-like.
That's absolutely right. For example, these two are after portraits of Botticelli. And Botticelli used to have that, you know, square of the window behind the portrait. And I like that a lot. And I thought it would be, you know, nice to put it in my painting. And black background also. An original painting of Leonardo da Vinci, its background is black, And it was very new at that time. It was kind of like modern priest, since he said that on black background the model, the image look more like dimensional. It brings dimensionality in the work. And so he kind of was innovative.
I just want to kind of underscore what Olga was saying about kind of the old juxtaposed with the new. For me, these are very contemporary pieces, mm-hmm. even though they have a, you know, very explicit linkage to past painting tradition and images that we all kind of interpret on an ongoing basis. We did not see the frames until she brought them in. She sent us a JPEG of the frames a couple days prior to this, and my colleague Nancy and I were like, we couldn't really make out what this was. They just looked like these chunky gold things, and I thought that's interesting. But when I saw them, you know, I just really loved them. Like, first of all, if you look closely, they're, even though they're kind of cut up and a little chock-a-block, it's very willful, and the craftsmanship on them is very interesting. And I don't know, it's just, again, kind of disaggregating that kind of very ornate Byzantine frame, and it's almost like she's reassembling the past on the edges there or something. It's really kind of effective, so well done.
My work is contemporary. I can say that for sure, because, you know, I'm using contemporary materials. I'm using the method of the contemporary, using photography. You know, I do have camera, and I do taking pictures by myself for my references. And also the printing of the old work is kind of contemporary thing. You know, the multiplying of the work that is somewhere. And I'm always amazed how original works still have the power to catch your eye and look at it for a long time. For example, like this one, I look at it over and over again, and there is no way I would be annoyed by it. How powerful is that?
That's my favorite.
Yeah.
Is that really her pet?
No. Like those pets, I just modified during the process. I found those pets. That one is from a special book about cats.
Hairless cats.
Yeah. So I just thought the cat is really original, you know. And a cat is kind of, you know, the woman king of also like a butterfly, like the less appreciated symbol of the freedom, you know, the sexual freedom, the freedom of being wherever you want to, you know. It's very difficult to control this pet, so I kind of want it back. And this one is, there is not too much symbolic in it. The person who I painted portrait for, she just wanted the same weird pet, but not the cat, so I just did that. Just wanted to paint your look weird enough to satisfy her.
Any other questions or comments for Olga? Okay, well, thank you all for coming out for our conversations with the artists. Really appreciate
thank
it.
Thank you very much.
Enjoy the show.